so underdeveloped, but see the systems they have. Why didn't we do? We should get leaner, no? All the time, if I see, because I travel a lot, I ask somebody in my house or my wife to go and pay the bills. So much a problem. Do this bill, do that bill, do that bill. Rwanda, the example I was telling you, if you want to register a company, they got some building, that office out there, I have seen that. It's a small country, not maybe bigger than Ahmedabad also. Just go there, show your passport, give your two photographs. There's a person sitting there on the computer. He'll check for your details. You pay money at the counter, it is registered. As simple as that. Nothing else is required. They will check whether the company name, duplication, etc. Everything is online. No paperwork, nothing. No come today, go tomorrow, or come tomorrow, nothing. 15 minutes, your company gets registered. 15 minutes. So simple systems. I'm not talking of developed countries now. I'm talking of real underdeveloped countries. They are so lean. So lean. But the whole thing is, now again coming back after these examples, is to see the muda. We are not able to see the muda. Observe the problems. Observe. If we are not able to observe the muda, we will never be able to reduce or eliminate the waste. Never be able to. God has given us beautiful senses. We should learn to observe the waste. We should see the good side which the governance is doing for us and maintain it. Just maintain it. Now, let me take you to one more larger picture. Gujarat, if we see the way it is being developed, I talk of Gujarat because we are all here and we understand better. It may be replicated somewhere else also, but I take this as an example because we all read about it and we know about it and we are staying here. Surat, textile city, little bit diamond hub. Ahmedabad, trading center, little bit of industries. Sanand, you have Nano, somewhere you have Maruti. Somewhere you have a solar park. Gandhinagar is all conferences and stuff like that. The Sachivalay, the government. Now projects are being released to make it more vibrant. Because they are saying, we do vibrant Gujarat, but it is not vibrant. Then we have Mundra Port, Kachbhuj. There are special zones. So industrialization is fantastic. What do you think will emerge? How it is going to be lean? Let's discuss this. So you'll get a larger picture.
Sir, at the first point was of transportation, I guess, interlinking of all these sectors, as it is being done right now, that the Mumbai, the Delhi-Mumbai corridor, all the industries are being developed on this corridor, and Gujarat is a major crunch of the part. So developing more transportation on that part would give a better access to the industries, and the ways of transportation can be reduced.
He says waste of transportation will be reduced. Okay, let's see. What else?
Sir,
yes?
Sir, roads are distributed among the regions of Gujarat. So, people don't want to shift one place to another for the sake of employment.
Okay. Okay, what else?
Unlike in Mumbai, I mean Maharashtra.
I'm talking from lean point of view. I agree what you are saying. That if you are in a particular area, you will get an employment there, so you are satisfied there. Fine, agreed. But I'm talking from lean point of view.
Communication
nowadays, you can be in different parts of the world, still you communicate. Clusters will emerge. Then how will it be leaner? Pardon? It can be interconnected. How? Through? That you can do from anywhere in the world. You can be sitting in Delhi and communicating here. How does it matter? After 3-4 years down the line, or maybe 5 years, when everything emerges, you're going to have fantastic flow. Fantastic. Okay? Why? One is, when we talk of flow, entry and exit is easier. You got two ports. One is there, one more coming up. So entry and exit is there. Now when we develop different areas in different parts of Gujarat, the infrastructure emerges. When infrastructure emerges, the muda of transportation and motion will be minimum, partly to what you were saying about employment. But employment is not the key. Muda of transportation and motion will reduce. Infrastructure is fantastic. All this is fine. So ultimately, the time taken for the services, which we call order to delivery, or from start to finish in simple terms, or to execute, will be the minimum. 5 years down the line. Trucks getting manufactured or car getting manufactured, 5 hours they are at the port. You've got a fantastic port, they are out. You need not go to Mumbai or somewhere else to, you know. So everything will be in the hub. And when flow, as I am saying right from the beginning, when flow is fantastic, you are bound to be developed. You are bound to be developed. Okay. Any questions? You are talking in public services or manufacturing?
In manufacturing or any business processes.
Okay. Any process, whether it's a... See, this, let me now take you a bit deeper. Manufacturing produces products. Business processes produce services. Both are factories in their own way. I take bank also as a factory. I take hospital also as a factory. Input and output is there. Now, I have listed down or spoken to you about the 7 types of mudas. Go, stand, identify the mudas and start working on them. Start working on them. Whether it's manufacturing or it's a service sector. I'll give you a simple example because I travel too much, so sometimes I think, now, okay. Now see, all the airports, if you see, are somewhat designed like this. You enter the airport from this side, then there are aircraft standing here, okay? Aircraft standing here, you check in, there is a waiting lounge, then they take you, then the baggage is coming from this side. Fantastic designs, no, airports? I see a lot of muda there. According to me, I should be standing straight, I walk in into the airport. Okay, there should be a conveyor, I check in, my aircraft should be there and I should be able to walk through. There should be 2 pockets, one is who are boarding the flight, one is who are about to board the flight. Why can't we make it linear? Why can't we make it linear? Sometimes I check, when I have to get my passport renewed, I go and talk to the passport office and then they do it, but after some time, the police come for verification. That's the standard. Whether I have committed a crime, they ask me, you committed a crime? Then I tell them, you should know better. Wo form ma lakhi hoy chhe. Have you committed a crime? Stupid, why are you asking me? You should know. And there are forms which are 20 pages. 20 pages. Why can't we have simple formats? If I have not committed a crime, better issue my passport. My neighbor has to vouch for me. Maybe he himself is a criminal. How do I know? Sometimes it's very stupid. No, you should see Muda. I am giving, maybe the government is right. I am not against anyone. But the thing is, see the problem. See the waste which we do. It's so genuine. It's so genuine. Sometimes I travel in a train. They ask me, can you show me your identity card? Then I pull out and I show my license. Now if you see my license, I don't have hair. Yeah, true. Because once I went to Tirupati and I lost my this thing, so I came immediately and I got a duplicate one without hair. You can't recognize I am the same guy. You know, sometimes it's very funny. Very, very funny. But because we have a process, we have to follow. And I'll stop this. I'll just share one more anecdote. Maybe most of you know it. This is about some monkeys. There are some monkeys in a room. And there is a ladder going up. So everybody wants to climb the ladder. And the monkey starts beating the one who is climbing. They don't know why they are going up. Okay? And then some monkeys are removed and some are replaced. And the new ones also start beating up the first monkey. They don't know why things are happening. Similarly, we have designed processes, whether in manufacturing or in daily life. We have designed processes, but we blindly follow because nobody has questioned us. Nor we want to question anybody. I go to manufacturing companies, so much things happening. When I ask them why this is happening, sir, 20 saal se aisa hi ho raha hai. Why don't you change? They don't want to change. The only thing, if you want a fantastic life and be in a good state, a developed state, identify the muda and try to reduce it and if possible, eliminate it. But muda will never be zero. Some of it has to exist. Okay? Any questions now? Any questions?
How to remove mudas from the government system?
Which system? Tell me.
So many systems.
Let us identify first. That I told you, there are 7 types of mudas. Pick up a system or a province sucked out of India. Then you have rupee depreciations. If they come into India, it depreciates. It's the reverse. Everything is governed by flow. Suddenly, there is no food in the market because of some reason, natural calamities and all. There will be sudden inflation. Okay. So you need to manage. Yes.
So I have two different questions.
Yes. That is our background. Any other questions? Any other clarifications required? Fine. Thank you. We can close here. Thank you.
What we got was more than expected. And thanks to Mr. Arora. One thing I learned, that lean can be so simple, that 7 mudas and then to the flow. And one perhaps mind block I got out of is that instead of blaming government, let us change our mindset. The government will follow. right? Like it has done recently, when we said assertively, this is what we want, corruption prevention and free India, the parliament woke up to it. So if we demand what, if we are clear as to what we want, the government has to give what we want. I have seen this in a cooperative housing society, where a lot of problems. And there are a lot of calls as it happens in any cooperative housing society. But then the ladies came on the scene and they focused on what is the basics, and things have started moving. I think one of the things is men are permanently confused. Okay, that is one thing I realized. That way the women are much more practical, and this is what it is. Their clarity, when the thinking is clear, things happen very fast. Okay? So, thanks to Mr. Arora, you have done a wonderful job. Thank you very much. Thank you. And thanks all to all of you for coming.
Thank you all. God bless. Take care.